What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Vid. I'm Katia, and today's lesson is going to be very different. We're not going to learn new vocabulary or break down grammar structures. Instead, I want to recommend 12 series on Netflix that I like in case you want to make the most of your summer holidays to improve your listening skills. Are you ready? If so, grab some popcorn and let's kick off. Before we start, I'd like to correct one pronunciation mistake that I made in the previous lesson, and it's about the word increase. It's quite tricky. If it's a verb, the stress goes at the end. To increase. But if it's a noun, the stress goes at the beginning. Increase. So the expression we learned in the previous lesson on the increase, the stress goes on the first syllable, on the increase, and not on the increase, on the increase. With that being said, let's begin. First, I want to talk a little bit about the importance of watching everything in English. If you watch movies and series in English, you can improve your English greatly. You can learn new vocabulary, improve your pronunciation, and develop your listening skills. If you're just starting, bear in mind that you need to be patient and tenacious. At first, it can be rather tough, and you might be tempted to go back to watching dubbed series and movies. So that's why you need to give it time, and little by little, you'll feel more and more comfortable. It happened to me like 9 or 10 years ago when I started watching everything in English. At first, it was a little bit difficult, because I felt much more comfortable watching everything in Spanish. But if you are constant and you continue watching everything in English, you'll see the result. And today I truly enjoy watching everything in English, and it's such a great feeling to be able to understand everything in its original version. So guys, now let's get started. I've made a list of 12 series that I've watched on Netflix over the past year or so, and I want to start with my favorite sitcoms. So the first sitcom I want to recommend watching is Modern Family. I've been watching it for many, many years, and this year I've seen the 10th season. There are 11 seasons, but the last one is not available on Netflix yet. So this sitcom is about a family who lives in Los Angeles, and it's so funny. The characters are just great. I think my favorite one is Phil, because he's a believer, so optimistic and enthusiastic. And if you're just starting watching series in English, I think it's a great choice, because the character played by Sofia Vergara will be very easy to understand. Now let's move on to the second sitcom on my list, which is How I Met Your Mother. I recommend this series to all my students. It's about a group of friends who live in New York. The main character is Ted Mosby, who is telling his children how he met their mother. It's a very long story that needed 9 seasons to be told. And my favorite character here is Ted, because he's so sweet and romantic. And I think it's also a very good choice for students whose level is A2 or B1. Now let's move on to the third sitcom, which is The Legendary Friends. It was voted as the best series of all time. There are 10 seasons, and I had so much fun watching it. And I think one of my favorite episodes is number 15 in the fourth season when Chandler is going to Yemen. It's hilarious. Let's continue. Number four, the Big Bang Theory. To tell the truth, it took me years to start watching this sitcom because I thought it wouldn't be my cup of tea. And I was clearly mistaken. It's a very funny series, and it's also about a group of friends, this time a little bit peculiar, and it's about their struggles, problems, and personal evolution. Totally recommendable. Let's continue. Number five, Gilmore Girls. Maybe this sitcom isn't as funny as the previous series, but I think it's a very good choice to develop your listening skills. It's set in a small town and it's mainly focused on mother-daughter relationships. There are 7 seasons, and the cool thing is that there is a bonus season which was made 9 years after the series was over. Let's continue. Number 6, Grace and Frankie. It's a very different sitcom because it focuses on problems and obstacles that elderly people have to face in their retirement. There are 6 seasons and it stars Jane Fonda. I had a very good time watching it and I think it's a very nice sitcom. Let's continue. Number 7, Virgin River. If you like romantic series, don't miss this sweet, feel-good romance. It's about a woman who moves to a tiny village and tries to make a fresh start after several traumatic events. For now, there is just 1 season, but I think the 2nd one will be released at Christmas, and I'm dying to see it. Let's continue. Number 8, Lock and Key. If you like magic, mystery, and superheroes, don't miss this series based on a comic. For now, there is just 1 season, but I think the 2nd one is in the works. Let's continue. Number 9, Bodyguard. It's the first British series on my list, and it was produced for BBC. It's very short, there are just 6 episodes, but it was so popular that I think and hope there will be another season. It's a political thriller about British politics and terrorist attacks. It's set in London and it stars Richard Madden, who, to tell the truth, I fell in love with. I just couldn't take my eyes off him, and actually I've seen this series several times. Richard Madden's accent is Scottish, so it was very nice to listen to this accent. And the whole series is fast-moving, intriguing, and the last episode is full of excruciating tension. So it's a must-see series. Let's continue. Number 10, Broadchurch. It's another brilliant British series. It's a drama focused on finding the killer of Danny Latimer. There are 3 seasons and it stars David Tennant and Olivia Colman. It's an addictive series that keeps your eyes glued to the screen, and there is also a great mix of accents. You can find RP, the Scottish accent, Northern, etc. So I recommend watching this series before your listening exam because of this wide variety of accents. And to finish, I want to recommend 2 travel programs because I love traveling. Number 11, Somebody Feed Phil. It's a travel documentary presented by Phil Rosenthal. He's an American guy, he's super funny and friendly, and he travels around the world and tries local cuisine. So each program is set in 1 city or 1 country. It's mainly about food, but not only, because there is also some sightseeing. I've seen all the programs and I recommend watching this program, especially before you're going to one of these places in order to get some ideas. And last but not least, my final recommendation is Down to Earth with Zac Efron. I've been watching this program this week and I really like it. Each program is about one city or one country, but it's not as much about food, but about finding solutions to problems like global warming or famine and pursuing healthier and more sustainable living. And I suggest watching this program before your English exam because you can get a lot of ideas about topical issues like environment, longevity, clean energies, etc. And you can also learn a lot of useful vocabulary. So it's a very interesting program in general and especially before your English exam. So guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this different kind of lesson. If there is another series that you like on Netflix and which I haven't mentioned in this video, please let me know in the comments below. And guys, I encourage you to pick one series and watch it in August. Please let me know what you're going to watch. And guys, if you enjoyed this English vid, it would be really nice if you could give this video a huge thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel and catch me on Instagram. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!